chote utataka nitakupa.
Do you stand by that translation or this translation?
Can you start the time?
Wait. We don't establish.
What translation have you got?
Exactly.
That's the problem. Exactly.
So
what's
Ali Yusuf? So there's a difference. There's a difference in translation. Your Bibles are messed up. Your Bibles.
Okay, so there's a picture.
Do you want to use this
one? Ali Yusuf.
Hello. Do you want to listen?
Look at all the other translations you've got.
Look at this translation. Look at this translation. No. We don't change the plural into singular.
Show me one.
Show me one translation of the Quran.
Don't change the subject.
Plural was changed.
That's right.
Don't change.
I can show you that.
I'm changing the subject.
No. Stick to this.
Okay. Same verse in this translation.
What translation is it?
And the book is delivered to him. Wait.
Cover the camera, brother, please.
Sorry. I'm reading the same
no timekeeper
in a different translation.
No timekeeper this time,
and,
yeah?
And the book. Because they opened the book.
So where's the time then? Where's the time then?
You don't like it?
No.
You don't like it? You don't want us to continue?
No, continue, but no time.
Okay, 2 minutes, a minute?
What's your problem?
We'll do.
Why did he stop?
He's just an outsider.
He agreed. He agreed. Are you a solicitor?
He didn't say that.
Are you a solicitor?
He told him.
Listen, he's happy. You want a dialogue.
I asked you, he said no. He said it would be a waste of time.
You want a dialogue.
The problem.
I said. Okay. You want a dialogue? He said no.
I remain silent until you
finish. He said no. Okay, let me finish.
What do you want?
So,
no. Wait.
Which one do you want?
Speak for 2 minutes then. Which one? Speak for 2 minutes.
So, no problem. What do you want to do?
I want to read this translation and show you how different it is to that one.
So you disagree with this?
Yeah, absolutely. I don't disagree with the Christians.
Okay. But you know what's interesting? What you're saying?
Yeah.
You're saying Muhammad is in the book, but you disagree with the book.
That's what God does.
You want to talk about that?
You're confused.
That's a new topic. I'm not confused. Do you know my view of the Bible? Do you know my view of the Bible?
Read what you have to read.
Okay. Same verse in a different translation. There we are told it's a group of people who are told to read the book.
Keep the time.
Here we are told it's one person.
Keep the time.
Here we are told it's one person. Amazing. No, what does that mean?
What does that mean?
Are you one or ten? How many are you?
What's your point?
Are you one or ten?
Okay. Your point is, this is Muhammad. Prove
you believe in the Trinity. I want to surprise
you. Now it's Trinity. Muslims always have to run to the Trinity when they get stuck.
Godwin.
When they get stuck. Okay? So read that and show us how this Muhammad is.
Godwin is three in one. He is Godwin the Son, God. Okay.
Read Isaiah and show us.
Isaiah 29:12.
Living.
And the book is delivered to him. That is not learned. Saying, read this. I pray. And he said, I am not learned. There you read, and when the book is given to them, and said to them, read this, and they say it.
Which one is right?
Wait, before we discuss it.
Woe to those who change the scriptures with their own hands.
Okay.
Adnan.
Listen, I have to pray now. Sorry, guys, I have to go. This is not getting anywhere. I'm running away.
You're not going to do it.
Shall I stay?
Stay.
It's not getting anywhere.
Verse 11. Again, where is it? 29?
No. Wait. Which translation is right? Which one is right?
Which one is right?
Read this one. Read this one. Wait.
Okay.
I said, the more you go into the hole, the deeper you will go into it.
Are you changing?
I'm telling you.
You say this Muhammad. Where is it Muhammad?
I will tell you.
No, I want to hear Muhammad. Okay. Verse 11.
Which verse 11. Wait.
No, wait.
Which Bible are we using? Which one? Which one are you using? Which one? Which one? Which one? Before we talk about Muhammad, which one? Which one?
You was using the same Bible.
Which one?
Choose one.
You choose one.
Do it properly, man.
Yes, let's do it properly. I'm asking you to choose one. Okay, you choose for him. Which one are we discussing? Which text are we? I'm not playing that game either.
I'm
insincere.
That's right.
Interpretation of the Christian doesn't matter.
Exactly. Absolutely. The meaning changes. The meaning changes altogether. If it's one person, then it's Muhammad. If it's a group, it can't be Muhammad. And do you understand the point? Wait, my friend. Fine. But do you understand the point I'm trying to make? If one... I understand that. I got the point. My point is, one text is saying, one translation is saying, it is many of them. Right? right? In that case, it cannot be Muhammad. It's out of the question. But one text is saying it's one person, right? So I'm asking which one is right.
For the context.
Which one is right?
Okay. And the context. Okay. I'm gonna do it for the last time. Okay.
Which one is right? Godwin.
Wait. Let me respond now.
I have the Greek one as well.
You want the Greek? I'm gonna respond again.
I have the Greek text as well.
Verse 11 is saying.
Read 10. Why don't you read 10?
You just read 12. I didn't tell you to read any other verse.
Read 10. It's only one more verse.
Let me read.
It's only one more verse.
Let me just make my point.
Why
it's only one more verse.
I wouldn't.
Read 10.
Okay, I read 10.
Yes.
But the Lord have poured out upon you the spirit of deep sleep and have closed your eyes, the prophets and your
rulers. And the prophets.
Let me finish.
The prophet.
Let me finish.
The prophet.
And the vision of God is become unto you at the words of a book that is sealed, which men deliver to one of his man, and saying, read this. So he's saying to the men, read this, I pray. And he said, I cannot, for it is sealed. Okay?
And the book is delivered to him. That is not learned. Saying, read this. I pray thee. And he saith, I am not learned. When did this happen in the history of humanity? Just tell me when and where. Which person? Forget about prophet.
It's not Bible, man.
When did this happen?
When did
this happen? And the verse 10 says, this prophecy is about prophets. Yes, the verse 10 says it is referring to prophets. It's talking to the prophets, right? Okay. So and now you change the Bible again.
Yeah.
Now you change the Bible again.
Yes.
No, no, because
listen,
this is Bible.
Listen, I have to pray, man.
No, this is Bible.
So what's from my Jimmy Swagger?
So okay.
It changes the Bible.
Godwin. Godwin. It's not helping you.
No, but
this topic is not helping you.
Let me tell you why. Let me tell you why.
Why you change the Bible? You're gonna tell me why you changed the Bible?
No, no, because you've been. It's not just my Bible.
But this is my Bible.
We have three here saying three different things. And it's not different. In wording or meaning, it is different in plurality. It makes a huge difference if it's a group of people or it's one person. Because if it's a group, Muhammad is out of the question. If it's one, then it is definitely, obviously, there is something.
If God
here.
Says I, okay. Ou,
Godwin, is it so hard to worship God alone? Is it so hard?
Can you take over?
Different subject.
Why do you need Jesus?
Different subject.
Wait.
Is this the person?
No. The next verse says that. 13. So what? So this is why we apply exegesis. Wait, I'm trying to explain now. We apply exegesis. What we do, we explain what the verse means. And Christian scholars, such as Otto Kaiser. Otto Kaiser is a German Christian scholar. I read his commentary. I'm talking.
You said you're talking to me. Let's talk to me.
Summarize.
First, but let's talk. Okay, summarize. He wants to go pray.
So God will have a timeout.
Verse 13. Wherefore the Lord.
I know what it says.
Wherefore the Lord.
I've read it.
Wait. Wherefore the Lord said, for as much as this people drew near to me.
These are different people.
Hold on.
This is a different. God is talking to different people.
Wait. For me, with their mouth. And with their lips do honor me, but they have removed their heart far from me, and their fear towards me is taught by the precept of men. So here it's clearly saying, wherefore the Lord says, for as much as the people draw near to me with their mouth.
Have you read any commentaries on this passage?
Honor, but I've removed. So,
simple
so
question.
Saying, so
simple question.
Why are you just
Godwin,
taking
why
one
are
verse?
You ignoring my question?
Why are you taking one verse?
Have you read any commentaries on this?
No, I haven't.
You
but
haven't.
I read the Bible.
Ask me the same question.
I read the
ask
Bible.
Me the same question.
What's your point about commentary?
Ask me
you don't believe what the Bible
ask
says?
Me
have you read the commentary?
Yes. Yes, I have Neil Jerome's commentary on this. I have read Otto Kaiser's commentary on this. I have read Christopher North's commentary on this.
And
they're saying these two verses are dealing with two different situations.
You're misunderstanding
people. And the verse 10 clearly states that these are prophecies about prophets, right? So if it's a prophet, then which prophet?
But it says you can read in the book.
Okay.
It says you can read.
Fine. Yeah, okay. I'm going to ask.
It says you can read. Fine. So could Muhammad read?
No, he cannot.
Right. So
no.
Why is it so?
The verse.
So okay.
You need to be consistent.
Godwin. You need to be consistent.
Did you understand what I said? I've read commentary.
Is this the only passage you have when a person can read? Is that the only passage you have? Is there anywhere in the Bible that says that?
It seems you're not listening to me.
No, because I've
It seems you're completely locked
I've listened long enough.
Completely blocked. You're not listening to what I'm saying.
The scripture says the person can read.
Can you clarify?
Yes.
I'm clarifying.
Clarify that point.
I said, I asked you, have you read commentary? You said no.
No, clarify from the Bible. The Bible's not commentary.
Okay. No, Bible does not explain itself. Bible does not explain itself.
Okay, no, listen, the Bible...
Okay, you're going to, again, you're going to fall in a ditch now.
No,
you're going to fall in a ditch. You're making a claim now. I'm going to ask you a question from the Bible. You're going to die here. No, I'm telling you. You're not going to escape. You're not going to run anywhere.
Clarify as that.
Okay. So you want, you understand the Bible from itself?
No, clarify
scripture, as that. Scripture.
Right.
But stick
give
on
me
that.
The Bible.
Stick
where's
on that.
The King James?
Stick on
yes,
that.
Yes, yes, yes.
He's trying to change the subject.
I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why.
I'm not changing the subject. You have not one time for our whole conversation given us a prophecy of Muhammad. Yeah? Right? You give me that lazy commentary which clearly states that the person can read.
Okay, good.
Yeah? You then say that Muhammad is illiterate and he cannot read. Okay. That's a contradictory. Oh, okay. Do you have any other prophecies in your Quran or in your Bible? Do you have anything in your Quran or in your Bible?
They got limited. Okay? They want the title.
States.
They want the title on reading. But
Muhammad is prophesied.
Okay, good.
Do you have anything in the Bible?
Can I respond now?
Yes.
I listen to you quietly.
Read.
Yes. I listen to you quietly. The reason why I use this particular passage is to apply Godwin's own standard to the Bible and show him that there is a passage which is more specific than the one he used for Jesus in Isaiah 53. And there is no other man in the history of humanity who had this experience.
He's giving you an example.
An angel came to Muhammad, so he claimed. Yeah. You can reject the claim. He claimed. And he said to him, read, and he said, I am not learned. And then the Quran was given. And the Bible says, when the book is given to the one who is not learned, and it is said to him, read, he will say, I am not learned. And the funny, wait. Now coming back to you, said,
but
I did not.
I'll
give you no prophecies, one by one. Number one.
That was an example.
Okay. Number one prophecy. First of all, did he do miracles? Yes, he did miracles. Number one miracle, he was traveling with over 1,000 companions, Prophet Muhammad. And this, let me finish, don't interrupt me. You ask me questions, and you can jump up and down and you can reject these miracles, yeah? Fine, no problem.
So is this in the Quran?
Okay, no, it's in the Hadith.
So it's not in the Quran. Is the Hadith?
You want something?
Hadith are better than the Bible.
Okay.
Quran is the word of God, right?
Okay.
Hadith is the word of God.
Did you say to me? Did you say to me initially that I want to show me Muhammad as a prophet from the Quran? The entire Quran is a testimony. He's a prophet.
Show us. How?
The Quran says.
How?
Surah Muhammad.
Okay. The Quran says, "Ma kana Muhammadun aba ahadun min rijalikum, walakin Rasulullah wa khatamun nabiyyin." The Quran says, "Muhammad is the messenger of God and he's the last of prophets." The Quran says that. That's your one verse. The Quran says that.
The Quran says
he's a prophet and as well as a messenger.
Okay.
Now Quran says that.
Okay.
Now what?
Okay. The Quran says that he's a prophet.
Yeah.
Okay. So how does that prove? So for example, if I come along, wait, hold on.
So let me respond.
Of course you're not happy with the answer. Quran says there are people whose hearts are sealed. Their eyes are closed. Their hearing is blocked. They cannot hear, they cannot see. Summun, bukmun, umyun, fahum la yarji'un. That's what the Quran says. There are people who don't want to know. They don't want to know.
You just said the Quran said he's a prophet, so he must be a prophet.
I didn't say that.
That's what you just said.
I didn't say that. You asked me where does the Quran say he's a prophet, and I gave you a verse.
No, I'm saying, I didn't ask you that, and you know I didn't ask you. Let me tell you what I did ask you, okay? You know, you're lying, right? I asked you, okay, where did he prophesy? That's the question I asked you. Right, I didn't ask you if he was a prophet.
I'm giving you one now.
Let me finish, right? Okay, so I asked you a prophecy, where did he prophesy? Then you went the Quran. I said,
thank you for the history. Thank you very much.
Now, I want to go back to my question, okay? Where is Muhammad? Can you prove Muhammad either prophesied or Muhammad did a miracle? Because you said that he
did. I'm giving the evidence.
Show us in the Quran where he did that. You haven't done it.
Why the Quran?
You haven't done it for an hour.
Hadith is literature. No, 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 hadith is scripture for us.
Okay.
Hadith is our scripture.
Okay.
Did you know that?
It's not a word of Allah.
Did you know that? Are you going to teach us Islam? Are you going to teach us Islam? No, you're going to correct me? Come correct me now. Come in front of the camera. Come in front of the camera.
Don't divert
it. So be quiet. Be quiet.
Tell your people to be quiet as well.
No.
Tell your friends to be quiet as well.
The Quran, okay, is that the word of God.
Hadith is scripture for us.
Hold on.
Do you understand that?
Okay.
Hadith is scripture for us.
Hadith is scripture. Yeah.
Yes. No, Bukhari is scripture. Bukhari is scripture for us.
Okay.
Yes.
Scripture. Okay. Yes. So is that the word of God?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So you see on camera that the Quran is the word of God, but also the Hadith is the word.
Is a revelation. Hadith is a revelation.
This ain't it.
Yes.
You see, basically, the Hadith is a continuation of the Quran, which was one word to Allah.
Right.
Okay, you're saying the Hadith is a continuation
of
that.
You want me to explain?
No, I need to be clear. You're saying, because we know that Muhammad received the word, Allah dictated.
You throw questions at me and then answer them for me. Is that fair?
I want to be clear. I don't want to run off.
The Prophet implements the Quran in his life.
You want to be clear?
Right, I want to be clear. So you're saying the Hadith is
the Quran is the literal word of God. I'm telling you now. The Quran is the literal word of God, word by word.
Yes.
Hadith is a complementary revelation which God inspired to Muhammad, and he explained the Quran.
By living it.
By explaining it. So whatever Muhammad said about the Quran is from revelation.
Yes.
It's not a literal word of Allah. Okay. So it's not the literal word of Allah. Yes.
We reject it though.
You can reject it. So what? We don't reject it.
Let's reject your Bible. Which one do you reject?
That's what I was asking. I'm saying to you that.
Do you understand?
I do understand what you're saying.
Thank you.
Now, what I want you to give me is what you consider, for example, I speak to Sunnis and Shiites and different denominations of Islam, and I disagree, okay?
What? What is he talking about?
And I don't know if the video ended here. I don't even know what happened. Otherwise, I think I've said what I have to say concerning these guys. At the end of the day, I think, just to end whatever they were saying, both of them believe one God exists, so both of them should live with that. They should end with that. I think as long as both of them believe God is only one true God, then life moves on. This was unnecessary. Where tempers are going up, whatever the case is, very unnecessary. But otherwise, God is God. Nothing will ever change that. I'll see you in my next reaction video.